which doesn't change year after year, day after day, life after life. It remains same. It doesn't change. Whereas the triangle with the apex pointing downward denotes towards our female principle, okay? And which keep changing every moment, every minute, every moment. And like you can say our body tells us that this is a female energy because our body keep changing every minute, every moment it keep changing. That's the reason we are born as a newborn baby and then we turn into a toddler, then into a young person, then middle age and then old. And then obviously all of us, we are all mortal beings, we die. But our soul, which remains inside, it never dies. The moment our body is unlivable, it becomes haggard, it becomes old, too many problems, too many aches and pains, then the soul leaves this body and gets into another newborn baby or new baby or a new body, you can say. It again starts changing. But without one of them, we don't exist. The life doesn't exist. So for the life to exist, both the energy is a must. Okay? So again, as I said, the upward triangle is the male energy. The downward triangle is a female energy. Now the female energy, it always moves upward. The male energy moves downward. And in Anahat Chakra, it merges and gives, and the another human being is formed. Now, it's a six-pointed star. The energy, if it is not given direction, it spreads all over. Like, right? As I said, that the 12 petals means energy distribution in 12 different directions. The energy spreads just like if you throw a stone in the water, in a pond or in a river, in a still river or in a pond. What happened? The stone create some waves, but it's always in a round wave, right? And whether you throw a triangular stone, a round stone, a square stone, but it always spreads, the wave always spread in round, in circle. In the same way, our energy spreads in all the direction because we have not given it a direction. Whereas when we start chanting the wonderful mantra, which I told you last time, it is young for Anahat Chakra. It starts moving upward. It gets that upward energy. And the merge energy of male and female principle, together it starts moving upward. And we give, and then our consciousness and everything start moving upward. And we slowly, and we get connected to our intellectual mind. That's what happens. So before moving up ahead and seeing the gland that this chakra controls, the Anahat Chakra, let's do meditation so that your mind becomes more focused. So, sorry, let's do that pranayam video, what we do every time. So, it's the morning time in Houston and the dusk time in India. So, it's a perfect time to practice our pranayam to get more focused, okay? And to give the upward energy to our energy, the prana that is moving in 72,000 direction. So give that upward movement to get connected to our intellectual mind to become more focused. Let's practice our pranayama, what we have been doing every day. Ravi, can we have that?
Can you hear us?
On your lap.
Yes.
Close your eyes and relax.
We can't hear it, Ravi.
Want me to play it, Raviji? Raviji, are you there?
Get it, Ravi.
Now, Brahmari. Yourself for Anulom Vilom. Assume the pranamudra with your right hand and begin. Left in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold Jalandhar 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Right out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold Jalandhar 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Left out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Left in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold Jalandhar 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Right out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold Jalandhar 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Left out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Left in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold Jalandhar 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Right out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold Jalandhar 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Left out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Release. Gently bring your right hand back to Gyan Mudra. It is now time for square breathing in sync with the Gayatri Mantra.
Om Bhurbhuvasvah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Nah Prachodayat Om Bhurbhuvasvah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Nah Prachodayat Om Bhurbhuvasvah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Nah Prachodayat Om Bhurbhuvasvah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Nah Prachodayat Om Bhurbhuvasvah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Nah Prachodayat Om Bhurbhuvasvah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Nah Prachodayat Om Bhurbhuvasvah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Nah Prachodayat Om Bhurbhuvasvah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Nah Prachodayat Om Bhurbhuvasvah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Nah Prachodayat Om Bhurbhuvasvah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Nah Prachodayat Om Bhurbhuvasvah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Nah Prachodayat
Your palms together, cup your eyes, and slowly open your eyes. हरिओम।
हरिओम। वेलकम बैक। नाउ योर बोथ ब्रेन आर वर्किंग एट द सेम टाइम, सो देयर इज कंप्लीट हार्मनी बिटवीन बोथ द ब्रेन्स। Because you must be knowing one thing about Anulom Vilom. Omkar Bhramari, I told you that Omkar activates all the chakras, all the seven chakras. Because when you chant Omkar, it has three sound vibration. A, U, Ma. And the beginning of Omkar creates vibration in your entire spine plus your stomach region. The center part of Omkar, that is U. You feel the vibration here. And the last part of Omkar, that is Ma, this whole part gets vibrated. We have all the important chakras located along our spine and in the brain region. So only if you have very less time, you can only chant Omkar. But do not miss your meditation. Because we have already sowed that seed inside us. And we need to get benefit out of it. But if you leave it, so you know, if you, when you just saw the seed and if you don't water it, what happens? It dies down. So don't let that happen. So what is the water and the fertilizer for your seed is regular meditation. That's what is important. Now comes back, let's come back to your Bhramari. Bhramari, when you chant Bhramari, you vibrate your entire this region. We have important chakras, as I said, the Agya chakra, the Bindu chakra, the Sahasrara chakra. All of them, they get vibrated. They start becoming more activated. They start becoming more active. Then Anulom Vilom, you know, you unblock the blockages in your Ida and Pingla Nadi. And as I told you in the beginning of the session, I mean to say in the first or second session, I told you that Ida is connected with your, when you are breathing in and out equally, when you're breathing in and out predominantly through your left nostril, your right brain is more active. Both your nostrils are connected with the brain activity. And at a time, you know, one brain is more active, that is either right or left. And you come to know by watching your breath, which nostril is more active. So whichever nostril is active, the other side of the brain is more active. So Ida Nadi, that is the left nostril, takes care of your mental activity. And the Pingla Nadi and the right brain takes care of your, the Ida Nadi and the left right brain takes care of the mental activity. Pingla Nadi and the left brain takes care of the physical activity. And when you do Anulom Vilom, what happens? By holding the breath, you activate both your brains. You start breathing in and out. You can check it out right now through both the nostrils. When both the nostril gets activated at the same time, means you start breathing equally through both the nostril. Your both brain, there is complete harmony between your left brain and the right brain. And it helps us to open up our intellectual mind. As I told you that at a time, on an average, a human being utilizes only 5-7% of the brain capacity. So what happened by doing Anulom Vilom, you open up that sky to you. And square breathing, again, during this COVID time, you must have heard that this square breathing is really very, very important. But this square breathing we do with the wonderful Gayatri Mantra. Again, Gayatri Mantra has 24 seed mantras. And when you chant it or when you do, when you hear it and do this square breathing, you start working on 24 elements of your body, 24 parts of your body, 24 corners in your brain of your body. So these four pranayama meditation is important to start your day. Okay? So let's get back to our chakra meditation. Ravi, can we have that video on Anahat Chakra? That is your thymus gland. The audio visual.
thymus glands are controlled by anahat chakra. Physically, thymus governs circulation. Emotionally, it governs unconditional love for the self and others. Mentally, it governs passion and compassion. And spiritually, it governs devotion. Thymus gland is controlled by anahat chakra. Thus, when it is
out of balance, one may feel paranoid, indecisive. Thymus glands are controlled by anahat chakra. Physically, thymus governs circulation. Emotionally, it governs unconditional love for the self and others. Mentally, it governs passion and compassion. And spiritually, it governs devotion. Thymus gland is controlled by anahat chakra. Thus, when it is out of balance, one may feel paranoid, indecisive, afraid of letting go, or unworthy of love. When it is overactive, one tends to suffocate people with love, which probably has selfish reasons. A balanced anahat chakra makes one feel compassionate, friendly, empathetic, and helps the person see good in everyone.
You are muted, Preeti ji.
Last time I told you that each and every chakra control one or two glands in our body. So anahat chakra controls a thymus gland. And one more thing I told you, I shared with you all, that each chakra, when you chant the wonderful beach mantra of each chakra, so the beach mantra for anahat chakra is yang or yam. Each chakra, when we are born with all the chakras, obviously, and each chakra is born with a default quality. What is the default quality of anahat chakra? It's love. Love, if untamed, can be for anything. Love can be for money, love can be for looking good, love can be for family people, love can be for everyone. So love doesn't have, like how the current is, wherever you pass that current, you can light a bulb, you can light your air condition with the current, or you can initiate a bomb. The current doesn't know. The similar way, the default, that love, you have to give it a direction. It can be turned into negative, it can be turned into positive. So it depends on you, how you are using it. So, it can become possessive. Again, we know how bad it is, how negative it is when a person turns possessive. A person turns greedy because of that excess love towards money or excess love towards materialistic thing. And in the whereas in the other hand, when you start doing meditation and all, this love turns into a positive quality. The unconditional love, the devotion, the compassion, passion, it changes into that. So it is completely in our hand in which direction to take this. If it's in the upward direction, the flower, that 12 petal flower, it flowers, it blossoms. And it along with that, it takes us upward in the towards the our heart, the moment our hearts start flowering, we can see the compassion, passion, devotion, love towards everything. When that happens, obviously, there's no sadness. And one more thing, the grief. Now, we all know that we are mortal beings. Whoever has taken birth has to die one day. But if we don't come out from that grief, we start blocking this chakra. So grief, the birth and death, is a natural thing. We cannot stop it. It's not in our hand. Whoever has taken birth has to die one day. So our near and dear ones also die. Even we will die one day. But we cannot be in grief throughout our life or for a longer time. When that happens, you start blocking this chakra. So love, it opens up the positive love. The negative love, it closes it down. You become more negative. And your consciousness starts traveling downward. And the positive love, it actually starts lifting you upward. Your energy starts moving in the upward direction. That's what it shows. And this chakra and the gland controls your air element. So just like air, as I said, it spreads. So we have to give one direction to everything, right? And now can we have the other video about the other chakra, Ravi? The Vishuddhi chakra. Ravi, there is no sound.
Raviji, you need to share the computer sound. While sharing, you need to share computer sound.
I'm sorry, do you want me to play that again with the sound?
If you manage a team, you should be...
You want me to play that once again with sound? Or?
Yes, because I don't think people understood. Because you need sound. You'll have to play it again.
The fifth most important chakra, Vishuddhi, is situated at the back of the neck on the path of the cervical spine. A blue lotus with 16 petals symbolizes the Vishuddhi chakra. The energy flows into this chakra from 16 dimensions. Vishuddhi is a partially negative and partially positive force, which can be made only positive through practice. In the center of 16-petaled lotus is a white circle, the yantra of the ether element, the Akash Tattva.
I don't know if you heard, but we just had a big development in the unfolding Spygate investigations. It's just been revealed that the
So we just spoke about the sixth important chakra, Vishuddhi. Now, I forgot to tell you about the meaning of Anahat. So let's discuss that first. Anahat means unhurt. Unstruck, sorry. And unstruck means which doesn't, each and every sound, when you struck it with something, when two things get struck, there's a sound. But anahat, unheard, unhurt, is the inner sound which you can hear only when you start meditating properly. Then only you can start hearing the inside sound. That's what it means. And I told you about all the glands, that each and every gland has four functions: physical, mental, emotional, and spiritual. So the gland only doesn't only like the hormone gets secreted and takes care of the body. No, it takes care of four things in our body. So when the gland, when the chakra gets activated and then it becomes balanced, it controls that gland, whichever gland comes into the periphery, and you get benefited in those all four sectors of your body: the mental, physical, spiritual, and physical. Okay, so let's talk about Vishuddhi chakra now. Vishuddhi chakra has 16 petals. 16 petals means 16 nadis, and 16 nadis means spread of energy in 16 directions. This energy gets distracted in 16 directions. When you start chanting the mantra, which has been dedicated to this chakra, when you start chanting that mantra, that is, what is that mantra? It is hung, H-U-N-G, hung, or H-U-M, hum. When you start chanting that, again, you collect all that energy from 16 direction and push it upward through your Sushumna Nadi in the upward direction. So, let me tell you, Ida and Pingla are common till this chakra, the Agya chakra. And rest, they are connected with all the other nadis. Again, each and every nadi or each and every channel is connected to different part of your body. So this throat chakra is connected with your hands, the movement of your hand, with all the other parts, whichever it takes care, because they are connected with your spine. So when you start doing meditation, it opens up your spine also. So if anyone suffering from the cervical pain or from lumbar slip disc and all, even that gets benefited. Because as I said, each and every problem, each and every disease, each and every pain is connected to your energy blocked, when you start blocking the energy in your nadis and all, then only do you start suffering from diseases. When the blockages remain there for a longer time, you start suffering from diseases or from aches and pains. So again, your slip disc or your cervical pain is also connected with that. So remember one thing, whenever you get stressed, if you're suffering from slip disc, if you're suffering from heart problem, if you're suffering from cervical, it again, the degree of the pain increases, right? So you can understand how it is connected with your mental activity, with the blockages of the nadi. So when you start meditating every day, it starts opening up. And you can feel a lot of difference in your pain also. You can see that. I was suffering. In fact, I was hospitalized for my backache. And let me tell you, the doctors all advised for surgery, that she'll have to go through under the knife. We'll have to open her up and we'll have to do surgery. But only with the help of meditation, sukshma pranayam, yogasins and all, I got saved and the surgery didn't happen, and I'm perfectly all right. It happened about 10 years back. Now, if you see me, like, nobody can say that I had a slip disc problem. I was hospitalized for 10 days. I was in the hospital, but no surgery, nothing happened. It got cured completely. So far, not a single attack, nothing, no pain, nothing. So as I said, meditation and all, it's an alternate medical therapy. It's a fact. You can cure yourself. You can manage your pain. You can manage your disease by meditating every day, by doing pranayama, the breathing exercise every day, by doing yoga asana, the postures every day. Because each and every yoga asana also opens up one of the chakra. Like Bhujangasana, if you have heard the name. Bhujangasana does work on your Vishuddhi chakra and your Manipur chakra. So similarly, your Gomukhasana works on your Anah chakra. So there are different asanas. Ardhamachindrasana works on your Manipur chakra. So you can do this chakra, yoga asana and activate your chakras also. You can work on your chakra by doing these asanas along with the breathing process. That is important. We have power yoga and all. They are effective, but they are just like the exercise, the gymming exercise. Yoga means merging. Because we just had a yoga day. What is yoga? What is the meaning of yoga? So you have to understand the meaning of yoga. Yoga means merging or unity of yoga, your physical body with your mind. And how do you do that? As I told you in the first lesson, the first webinar, that breath is the only tool through which you can enter inside. You can connect your internal body with your outer body. Breath is the only tool. Your breath gets distracted whenever you're suffering from any of the emotion. Like when you're angry, your breath becomes fast. When you are stressed, your breath becomes very slow. So your breath there is effect on your breathing process the moment you're suffering from any of the emotions. So remember one thing. When yoga means again, so the power yoga, no one is concentrating on their breath. It is done very fast. In 30 seconds or so, and maybe less than that, you finish one Surya Namaskar, the round of one Surya Namaskar is possible. Because it has 12 asanas or postures. And you have to do it with the proper breathing process. Breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. That's how it is done. And it opens up each and every chakra of yours, all the 72,000 nadis of yours, when you do it with the proper breathing process. That's what I wanted to dedicate for the yoga day, the 21st June. So now you know the Beej Mantra for this chakra, Vishuddhi chakra, is Hung. And when you chant, start chanting that, it starts opening up this portion of the body and your entire body, you get connected to your brain. We have thyroid, parathyroid gland. It affects on that chakra also, on the Udo's gland also, which we'll be discussing in the next session. So Ravi, can we start that meditation now? It's only audio. No video is attached.
Take your positions, sit with your back straight, with your hands in Gyan Mudra, resting on your lap. Close your eyes and relax. Relax every part of your body. Let's begin with Omkar. Begin. it is time for chakra meditation. Mooladhara chakra, located above the anus. Now, Beech Mantra, begin. Adhishthana, located just below the tailbone. Now, the Beech Mantra. Begin. Located right behind our navel on the lumbar spine. Now, the Beech Mantras. Begin. Thank you. It is time for Anahat now, located behind the heart on the path of the thoracic spine. The Beej Mantras begin. On the path of the cervical spine. Now, Beej Mantras begin. Universal mantra. Om. Begin. Your palms together, cup your eyes, and slowly open your eyes. Hari Om.
Hari Om. So that was all about Vishuddhi Chakra. We'll be discussing in the next webinar about the parathyroid gland and thyroid gland. Because these two glands are connected with Vishuddhi Chakra, and Vishuddhi Chakra controls the secretion of this gland. Okay, now if you have any question, let's answer that question, Ravi. The last session, somebody was asking a question and we couldn't finish that.
We don't have that question here again, but the lady was an asthmatic, mm-hmm. and she was trying to find out about the breathing for the asthmatic people.
So in the first session, we spoke about the Brahma Mudra. That's really a wonderful, it's a yogasana pranayam, is a wonderful technique for asthmatic people. Because in that Brahma Mudra, you with each and every exhalation, you put oxygen in each and every ventricular of in each and every chamber of your lungs, and the entire carbon dioxide come out. So if you remember that Brahma Mudra, otherwise we can Ravi, you can share that video once again. I'll share that video and she can see it and practice that. That's a wonderful technique. And Anulom Vilom, Omkar Bhramini, all these pranayam also do help. first in the asthma.
Vipinji, you want to do questions or?
I can see three questions down there.
Okay. Ida Nadi controls the mental activity or physical activity?
It controls the mental activity.
My head.
It's a feminine nadi, let's say that. Feminine.
My head gets heavy after meditation. Am I doing something wrong or is it normal?
Sorry?
My head gets heavy after meditation.
Yeah, it's bound to happen because so many years of that, you can say, the unwanted things we keep preserving in our brain. So the whole system is trying to get rid of that blockages which we have collected over here. So it's trying to declutter the whole things. So it's initially it may get heavy, but with regular practice, within a few days or months, weeks, you will say that this heaviness goes away completely. And you start feeling more lighter and much better and happier.
What is the young age chakra breathing can be performed?
I didn't get that question.
What is the young age chakra breathing can be performed?
The teenager, they can start doing it.
Of course, when somebody asked about last sessions, they missed Ravi. They can contact Raviji and Raviji will give it. How many times is the yang and yang mantra to be?
Each and every mantra should be chanted minimum for 8 times. Minimum 8 times.
And similarly, how you many know, times were the Om at the beginning?
Om 3 to 5 times or 7 times. It depends on your timing and all. These guided meditation is only till you learn all the mantras, all the location and all. The colors are involved with it. Once you learn everything, then you should do it without hearing it. So you can lose yourself in any of the chakras. If you want to remain in one of the chakra for a longer time, suppose people suffering from diabetes and all or acidity, they can be in their Manipur chakra for a longer time. So once you memorize everything, you can be there. If someone is suffering from asthma, the lady asked, can remain in Anahat chakra for a longer time. But it's a must to do all the Bij Mantra chanting of all the 7 chakras. It's a must.
Should we focus on color, shape, etc. while doing particular chakra? That is red for Muladhar and yellow for next.
Yeah. It depends completely on your experience. Whatever you see or experience, you can focus on that. Some of the people, so a few of you may not see any color, may not see the shapes of the chakra. So it doesn't matter because it's working within
is it okay
you.
To lean so don't worry. Is it okay to lean your back on support while meditating?
No. Your back should be straight. You can support, but you cannot. As I told you last time that animals also have chakras, but unfortunately they are in the horizontal position. And we human beings are the only beings in this world who are straight. And the consciousness always moves upward to get connected with the intellect mind and the divine being and everything to open up all the centers. Energy has to move upward. We are the only fortunate being. So it is important to keep your back straight. You can take back support, but the back has to be straight.
There are many more. We'll take last 2 questions.
Yeah.
Your back pain, should you do this exercise and can it help?
Exercise? Yeah. Or you, is she meant to say?
Yeah, that's what
or
she has written. But probably meant meditation. You have.
Yeah, meditation should be done. You can take back support, but again, not in the lying down position. You have to sit. You can sit in a chair. If you can't sit in the bed and all, or you can't sit down, doesn't matter. You can sit in a chair, take the back support and do meditate. It will help you. As I told you, like my experience, that it helped me. It cured my back so far. I haven't got a single attack, nothing. whereas the doctor said that I have to go for the surgery, but nothing happened, and touch wood, thank God. And it's been 10 years since that happened.
So same, I think the last question we'll take. It can never be ending, otherwise there are so many questions, and thank you for questions. So you had mentioned about teenagers can do it. So there is a teacher, and she feels, she or he, I don't know, whether there should be any warning against younger children practicing, because she's trying to work, encourage meditation in schools here.
Initially, the kids should be taught Omkar Bhramari and Anulom Vilom. And then slowly, they should be given lectures on the Ida, Pigla and all, the left nostril, right nostril. Because unless and until they are explained about the science behind it, they will not understand. And yes, all the teenagers can then start meditating on this.
But there's no warning required.
No, there is no warning required, because it will help. Basically, what we are doing, we are making our energy move upward by meditating on this. It will benefit everyone. Whoever does it, it will benefit them. It will not harm them.
I think we'll end there. You want to say something, Raviji or Preeti?
Preeti, one more question. The lung, Wang, Rang, all these, they have to be practiced a certain number of times, or you can practice them as many number of times as you want?
I think this was answered.
Minimum eight times. And it can, you can increase a number, but minimum has to be eight times. Okay. But as per your comfort level, as per your, whatever you are feeling, you can increase the number, but not decrease the number.
Okay, we have one last question about the problem is I can't go on till the last Gayatri Mantra square breathing. I get breathless and I feel a little pain in the chest. This is from
asthmatic. Yeah, for that I did explain that you can extend your exhalation longer. So you must be finding it difficult when you hold it after exhalation. So you can increase your exhalation. Still, if you can't do it, you can create a triangle out of it. Triangle means you can breathe in, hold your breath after breathing in, and then breathe out. And instead of breathing it, holding it again, you can start breathing in. So in three rounds of Gayatri Mantra, you will finish four rounds of breathing pattern. So you can create a triangle rather than a square. So instead of as I told you, inhale and then Bahya Kumbhak, Antarik Kumbhak, when you hold your breath after inhalation and then exhale, and don't do Bahya Kumbhak, that is holding your breath after breathing out, then you will not feel any pain and all. And then you'd start doing it once you are comfortably doing all these three, that is triangle. Then introduce the Bahya Kumbhak also. That is called Shunya. You can do that. Otherwise, you can extend your exhalation and you will not find it difficult.
Thank you, Preeti ji. Thank you, Vipin ji, for bringing this to all of us. I have one request to all the attendees that please log in before 8 o'clock. When we start, or 6:30 India time, try not to be late. Thank you, and see you all again next Friday.
Thanks.
Thank you very much.
Namaskar.
See you all.
Shubhratri.
Thank you, and have a good day.
Thank you.